opposite to what it was yesterday, as we see Cho Sung-hoon take his guard. He's taking a middle and leg. 25 years old, Cho. And at the other end is Seol Il-won. Opting the bowling will be Nazrul Rahman. So there's the field, two down on the boundary on the offside, deep forward of point and a third man. So obviously he'll be required to keep it on off stump and outside there, the 21-year-old Nazrul Rahman. Got a 4 for 37 a couple of years ago against Nepal in Abu Dhabi. And a 5 for 18 against Oman at the same tournament. So a rich streak of form then when he was just 19 years old. Rahman. Oh, it's not a bad first delivery. Handled reasonably well by Cho. Played underage for Malaysia in the under-15s and under-19s, Nazrul. Just must be a left-handed batsman here. Sure. I know he's a right-hander, but they've obviously know something about him. They've dropped the man on the offside at point cover and brought somebody in on the leg side for the down of the boundary there. Of course, in T20, the first six overs, only two players allowed outside the inner circle, and pulling the wide, maybe just trying to set him up for a big shot through square leg from the catch. Obviously some philosophy there, strategy. Takes the front edge there. Played the shot a little early, trying to guide it through leg. In Malaysia, a cosmopolitan nation with the local Malay population dominant in numbers, and good to see so many of the Malays playing cricket here. A lot of Indians over the years, of course, with their popular pastime, but more and more we're seeing the Malays playing in as we just inspect the pitch. And that has been of some concern in the last few days, keeping very low and slow, hard to get your shot making going and your timing right on a wicket like this. A couple of bounces low predominantly, but then the odd one will pop up, getting a crack or two. And just shooting off the seam. Noticeable how much slower the men play it compared with the women with the longer run-ups. Boy, we shot through the overs with the women's competition. What a canny piece of running there from so he gets off the mark as well. A very young cheerleading outfit to the Koreans. So it's Cho back on strike. Straight to the fielder at mid-wicket, and that's the end of the first over. Just two runs coming from it. but no wickets lost for Korea. So it's Suharil Swab. We'll open the bowling from the other end. It looks like he'll be coming off a short run up too, so spin bowler with a new ball. See if he can get any purchase on this.
Come on, boys. Let's keep the pressure on, boys. Come on.
Wicketkeeper there chirping away. Well, that's a direct hit. Could be close, not out. Good running. Well, calling very positively, these two opening bats people. It's good fielding. And you can see there with the benefit of the replay that he was a couple of inches short. But a tough call for the umpire there, working on the blind side of the wicketkeeper. So, getting the benefit of the doubt. So, Ilwan facing up.
That's good, Danny. That's good. Dot ball we want, boys. Well done.
Shafiq Sharif, the wicket keeper, talking us through what they need and going right between his legs. Probably come back for it. No, they're going to hold it there at one. Probably a wise decision there. Took off late, the batsman. He didn't really know where the ball was. Ilhwan.
That's good, boys. That's good. Keep going.
So
just a single. Don't matter, boys.
Shafiq. Suharil, the bowler. Chops down on it into the cordon of fielders on the offside, and I'm sure Korea will be aware of the law regarding the fielders and trying to push through. He shaped there to come down the pitch, just thought better of it. And sometimes the difficulty for the batsman when an off spinner or a spinner is opening the bowling, they're not quite used to facing them first up, so it takes a while to get into their stride, usually ready to see the ball come onto the bat more. So that's a good over, just two from it, and Korea four without loss after two. Azril back at the bowling crease and wide of the fielder, so they take a single. They'll need to tick those over, that's for sure, and probably start getting on to this medium pacer. Take a few risks. It's a nice throw, but well home the Korean. Oh, again, they're taking on the fielder, and that's great running. Isn't this awesome? Obviously, some of these Koreans playing baseball in their time and used to stealing bases. And the Malaysians realize they're in a game here as far as their fielding goes. Very smart between the wickets so far, the Koreans. Hit this one quite a bit harder and gets home again. Well, obviously, if you're the fielder at mid-off, you have to start thinking about just taking a couple of paces forward. Because why are you there? Why are you in that position? You're there to cut off the single. Otherwise, you're in no man's land. It might be just worth taking a couple of paces forward. Obviously giving them a better chance to squeeze the ball past you, but at the moment in their mindset is just prodding and running. See, they're the mid-on, quite a bit further up. It's a good fielding from the Malaysian at mid-on. Suresh, another Ratnam. Israel. Well, that's a good stroke. Bold, confident stroke, and four runs. Good to see. And you can see an element of baseball about that shot. Cho Sun Hung, who'd been hanging around a bit, he'd only scored 3 off 11. So that's pushed up his scoring rate somewhat. And they really need to do this, the Korean men, in this first six overs. Take advantage of it and play each ball on its merits. Good ball there on the spot from Israel. And that's the end of the third over. Korea are 11 without loss. So it's Suharl with his second over. Oh, he spooned that up. Oh, how did that miss the short cover there? And he's got away with a run too. Seo is slightly embarrassed. Well, you take him while you can. Arudin just wide of him. Suharl serving in the Air Force for Malaysia. He's certainly got his flight worked out here, hasn't he? As far as bowling goes. Nice low trajectory and very hard to move your feet up the pitch to him. Well, that's exactly what they've done this time though. There's a man down at long on. And he's fielded really smartly. That's nice work. So they move to 12 through Seo's single. Oh, that's nice too, just getting his head over the ball out to mid wicket. Oh, the run too as well. That's brilliant work. That really is good stuff. And kudos to Julian Fountain here. These Korean men have been really well drilled in their running between the wickets. No messing around. That was one area we thought the women were a bit shabby, not just for Korea, but right through the competition, especially the minnows. Oh, he spooned that as well, but got away with it. Just quite a bit of bottom hand in those shots through mid-wicket. And this is a good over for Korea. Turning over the strike well. And if they can get some runs off this last ball, they can tick this one off as a positive over. I can't wait to see some of these ex-baseball players coming in the last few overs. Nice bowling from Suharil. And that's the end of the fourth over. 16 without loss. Korea doing well. So a bowling change here by the looks. So Suresh Navaratnam. He's been around for a while. He'll be 39 next week, Suresh. I need to practice the run up, and he goes. Oh, and that's an odd decision by the batter. Just turning around mid pitch. A little bit of doubt there. Made his debut for Malaysia 21 years ago against Singapore, Suresh. So, a real warrior. And bowling at quite a fast clip for a 39-year-old. Suresh. Looks up to his father as a hero and also likes Javed Miandad and Steve Waugh, as well as Kirtley Ambrose from the West Indies. Won a series of awards during his career. Man of the series in the 2002 Asian Cricket Council Trophy. Which is a great achievement, as we see. So, on face, he's on 7 after 11 balls. Tried to steer that one through the slip region. So Suresh immediately putting the brakes on the scoring here. Wonder what that little cutthroat signal means. Does that mean he's going to come up the wicket, maybe? Just an over and two balls left of the power play. So they really need to take advantage of that, Korea. Again, tucked up. Good line there from Suresh. And this is a golden over for the Malaysians. With Suresh bowling a nice tight line. Ball of the over. Can't get onto it though, so a maiden there for Suresh Ravanarum. Great job in holding back the scoring rate for Korea. They are still 16 without loss after 5. So another change in the bowling attack down the other end. Shaul Nizam. Or Nizam to his mates will come on, bowling his left armers. Thick edge there, but it's beaten the fly slip. Suresh gets it, but not before the run 3. Goodness me, that's good running from the Koreans. Such an athletic bunch, aren't they, these two? Like greyhounds scooting up and down the wicket. A lot of pace on that first delivery from Nizam. 24-year-old left armour. Better ball. Taking his time, having a think about what he wants to do with this next delivery. Just bringing it in with the arm, honing in on off stump. And the Koreans, after a nice start, just slowing down here. This is the last three balls of the power play. Only two fielders allowed outside the circle. And that was there to hit. He's done that too. That's a nice little shot. Nifty. Will it go to the boundary? It's slowing up, and that's a good chase from the Malaysian duo out there. But that's the type of shot you need to play in these first few overs. Little scoop over the top of the field. Good camera work there too from the Korean crew. It's been an interesting experiment for them, I'm sure.
That's good.
Shaped to come up the wicket, but Nizam, not worried, just went about his business, put the ball on the spot again. Well, we've seen in the women's competition that a score around 100 was a very good one. Oh, he's got that through. Fielder there back with a point, gives it the Big Harbour Bridge. Gets 5 points for the dive, but lets two runs through. So that's the end of the sixth over. And Korea haven't lost a wicket yet, but just 23 on the board. So Suresh Ravanatram will start his second over, and well, they're allowed an extra fielder or two out now, and they've taken that opportunity to bolster the offside on the boundary. Gave that one some work, Suresh. At the 123-125 mark in pace. Of course, if these Koreans had played top-level baseball, it's pretty easy to pick up for them. Baseball pitches coming in at around 130, 140, 150 kilometres an hour. Cho Sang-hoon. Timing wrong there. Just sense that the Koreans need to take a few more risks here, as Suresh has really battened them down, tied them up a bit. Faiz talking to his fielders out there on the offside, so that ball slightly slower, 116 kilometres an hour. We saw in the women's competition 100 a good score, so it'll be interesting to see how the men go here. I think with their superior hitting power, a score of 120-130 reasonably achievable, even with the low bounce. But I don't think these two hitting is their forte. Smaller builds. We saw some lanky lads in the Korean squad though. Some good height for medium pace bowling. Wallops that one pretty straight. And again, very, very good running. Nice fielding too in the deep there. Got it to the wicketkeeper's end and put a bit of pressure on the runner. Well, that was a quick over, wasn't it, from Suresh? Seven gone already and just 25 without loss. So both batsmen on 11. Cho has his off 22 balls. Seo off 19, and a strike rate of around 50 to 60 for both of them, which is probably not enough. I mean, it's great that they've been able to keep their wickets, as we see the young star in the making, Parvin, come on. He'll be bowling left arm round.
Come, boys.
Talking of Lanky, he's quite a tall man himself, and we see there too from the first delivery a lot more bounce. That one though keeping reasonably low, and being able to just flick it through point. Keeper just asking for the throws to be thrown up a little bit. Scooting along the ground. Cho facing up to Pavan. Pavan's just 16 years old. It's his birthday in January, so real tyro in international cricket. Well, he's hit that up in the air. There's a man down there, and it's bounced just in front of him there. So a let off there. Parvin won't mind that though, giving him every chance to get some wickets. Bagus, bagus means good in Bahasa Malayu. Down to the same spot. They're teasing the man down there, aren't they? I mean, golf's very popular as well in Korea, and that's very much like a 9-iron shot. Two deliveries in a row. Here's the last ball of the over from Parvin. Steps back nicely, and there's another single. Eight gone, just 28 without loss for Korea. Well, we see the busy Saturday morning traffic there in the background in Yonghui. Location of the main stadium here at the Asian Games 2014. This is the first morning of the men's competition, the first match, in fact, for T20 cricket. Malaysia are taking on Korea. Korea at this stage are 29 without loss. And here's Farooq Azmi, who comes in for his first over. Selection of slow bowlers here for Malaysia. Very popular in Southeast Asia to have a coterie of slow bowlers with the climate the way it is. Fast bowlers become slow bowlers very quickly. And on the Singapore club scene, we get a lot of young tearaways coming from both India and the West, coming off their long run-ups of the first few games, and then at 35 degrees and 100% humidity after a few games decide to just come off a shorter run-out. and slowly morph into medium pacers or spinners. Farouk, interesting little tuck shot there into a hole as well, thinking about two, but Parvin gets around and covers. Farouk, the bowler, one of the many in the Malaysian team who bat right-handed but throw and bowl with their left. Slowing down a bit, the Koreans there. There was two there based on their past experience. Just deciding for the single. Well, maybe they know something that we don't. Maybe the Korean batting death is not that strong, because really one of them should be taking a few more risks. Let's see if it's at this stage of the innings where they come out. Now, it was definitely a big swing, and it's all for nothing anyway. It's a swing and a miss and a stumping there for Shafiq, and it's Farouk who gets the first wicket for Malaysia. Well out of his crease there, and pretty slow on the reactions there, Seo Il-hwan. So the first wicket down for Korea. Might be a bit of relief if we can get somebody in who can be a bit more aggressive, but a good start for Seo. He set them up nicely, and he'll be dismissed for 14 off 23. To know is how he can keep his hair immaculately in place under that helmet. It's got the K-pop style. Two deliveries left in this over from Farouk, and the introduction of the new batsman. Enjoying the occasion and the support. I'm sure he doesn't get this every Saturday at the local league, Sung Dai Sik. Let's hope he can keep his fans happy by belting a few runs around the park. Yep, and he's got it up in the air anyway. Oh, it's very aerial and well taken. He's only lasted a ball. So he came in to force the scoring, Sung Dai Sik. But it's a long walk in and a long walk out with not much activity in between there for Dai Sik. See the baseball style there, can't we? And well taken in the end. Farouk is happy. Second wicket. The crowd still giving him a big clap on his way out. So nine overs gone, it's 32 for two. So this is Lee Sun-wook, he's a 28-year-old, comes in at number 3 a lot for Korea, so they obviously put Dai Sik up there to see if he could give them a little cameo, lift the run rate. Here's Parvin, 16 years old. Oh, that one's turned too, isn't it? Named as one of the best bowlers at a recent under-19 tournament, so certainly playing above his age as we see the demise of Dai Sik. Parvin in with his second delivery. And beats the fielder two there at the short mid-wicket, so they get a single. It's been a while since we've seen a run.
Well done, boys. Well done, boys. I keep going. Dot balls. Dot balls, boys.
Well, that's a nice little slice off the thick edge of the bat. They'll come back for two. Faiz goes down and flicks it to his teammate who wasn't looking. Played for that. And did well. Do you just get it inside the fly slip there?
Well done,
to the fielder. So we have Sung Wook and Sung Hoon in at the moment. Cho Sung Hoon is on 18 off 31.
Catch it!
Has that gone far enough for the fielder? Yes, it has. Oh, lovely slide by Amin. Made a lot of ground to get there. So Parvin has his first wicket. Flights it up nicely and does a good job there, made a lot of ground very quickly, then suddenly realised that he had the chance of overrunning the ball, put on the brakes, and now Korea are three wickets down, falling pretty quickly here, and Cho Sung Hoon doing a good job starting the innings off, 18 off 31. Angry at himself, obviously getting a start. And just as he got his eye in, not having the power to get it over the long arm. So two new batsmen, Lee Sung Wook, will be joined by Choi Ji-won. Lee facing, they cross the batsman. And that's the over from Parvin Singh. 35 for 3. Well, we've seen the ball struck in that region quite a bit as they've gone for the drive. And Amin probably just coming in a couple of steps as well. Making it ultimately easier for himself. So we're halfway already through this innings and 35 for 3. A brave effort, but I'm sure they'll need a few more runs up their sleeve to have any chance of defeating the Malaysians. Here's Farooq, who got two overs for three runs in his first over. Two wickets for three runs. So there's a wide delivery and there'll be byes as well here. They'll run, come back for two, so that's three runs and an extra ball. Farooq made his debut against Afghanistan in 2012 from Kedah in Malaysia. It's a lot fuller. Lee not really taking advantage of that one.
Keep going, boys. Well done. That's good. That's good.
Going down leg, surely. Oh, he's given it out. The umpire from China. That's, oh dear, oh dear, Choi Ji-won. I'm not sure if he's new to cricket, but even he's looking back at the wicket in disbelief. Let's watch the wicketkeeper here. Let's see where he goes. no real turn there, and bowling from right outside off stump, hitting him on leg, middle and leg if you're lucky. But the itchy finger goes up, and Choi Jiwon has a duck only after three balls. Farooq's happy though, he's got his third wicket. This is Bung Swin. ...31-year-old... and lists his hero as Mahendra Singh Dhoni. MS Dhoni, the Indian captain. Well, hope he has the same stylings as Dhoni. We're in for a treat in the last 9.5 overs if he can bring some of Dhoni's game to his own. Farooq, three wickets now. Interesting there, with a lot of tape on his spinning fingers, Farooq. Obviously been doing a lot of work in the nets and chafing his second and third fingers there. It's gone down leg two, and Bung is off the mark. So that's the over for Farooq. In fact, there's one more with the wide. Lee just checking his guard. Sam Walkie's faced three balls just for the single. It's a good little single into the gap too. Farooq scampers and fields his own bowling all the way over by the square leg umpire. That's keenness for you. So the end of the 11th over, and Korea, after starting brightly, now 40 for 4.
Come boys, come boys.
Parvin still on with his third over, has 1 for 7.
Catch it.
Thick edge, goes to point. Lee obviously one of those little flickers with the bat. Doesn't have a huge back lift. Good for one a ball though if he can find the gaps. Bung Swin. Sounds like a name of a man who can hit the ball very hard. Mr. Bung. Not interested at the moment, just getting his eye in. As I mentioned, Parvin Singh, named most promising player at the ACC Under 19 Elite Tournament in Malaysia. Just 15 years old at that stage, I guess, so developing very well as a cricketer. He's a wonderful physique for a bowler. Thinking of the Daniel Vittori style bowler, isn't he? He's lanky and uses his height well, and that's a wonderful delivery from Bang, from Parvin, and he's got Bang out. Stumped, as easy as that. Mr. Cool there, Parvin, the 16-year-old, not celebrating too much. He took a nice piece of turn there, and Bang, never on his ground. Thank you. be interested to see the Korean bowling attack, but they don't look very comfortable against spin bowlers, do they, the Koreans? And seem to have no idea about getting their foot back into the batting crease. So five down now for 41. Doing a good job behind the stumps there, enjoying his day so far. Two stumpings, one to Farooq and one to Pavandeep. Pavan Singh's got two wickets now off his two overs, and the new batsman is Park Taekwon. There's the captain, Park. He played baseball from about to the age of 12, as we see a high back lift there from Park. Couldn't get into the national team, so when an opportunity came up to represent Korea in cricket, he took it, as we see the wicket here of Bung Suin. Pretty regulation left arm spinner dismissal. Straightening up nicely, beating the edge of the bat, and the batsman out of the crease. So here's the action so far. High score from Cho, who opened the batting with Seol down there in the number 7 position in the card. But, they opened and they looked good. They looked promising. We just wondered why they weren't being a little bit more aggressive, and I think the reason is the batting depth of Korea. Not very strong. What you going to see in developing cricket countries, Farooq? Ooh, yes. He manages to scoot one off the side of the bat there. Farooq with a good first couple of overs. He's got 3 for 9. Making a field adjustment for Park, who looks like he's going to open up pretty soon, you'd imagine. Watch this big high backlift. I think if he gets something in the zone, he'll give it a go. The Korean captain tries his best to avoid opening the bowling. And as captain, I guess he can, he's in a good position to do that. Well, the anchors have gone on, haven't they, in this innings. We thought when they were running along at 3 or 4 and over, it was reasonably slow. But as you see, the last 5 overs, just 16 runs and 5 wickets. Farooq, nice ball, and he's finished his third over. Korea 42 for 5. Good bowling from the two left-armers. Parvin 2 for 8 off 3. Farooq 3 for 9 off 3. Parvin continues and gives him a nice big lollipop to take 2. Oh, it was tight. Direct hit. Would have been trouble. And Lee, he's accumulated well. He's on 6 now off 8 balls, so doing well as the young 16-year-old thinks about how to deal with them. If you're watching in Malaysia, selamat pagi, and hope you're enjoying our coverage here of this T20 International between the hosts Korea and Malaysia. First match of the men's competition in the T20 cricket tournament.
Good boys, good boys, good boys.
As we mentioned, two pools of three teams in the early stages. The other team in this pool is China. The other group's made up of Nepal, Kuwait, and the Maldives. Nice shot through the covers. Just a single to lead. So the top two from each pool make their way through to the quarterfinals. The four seeded teams are Bangladesh, Afghanistan, Sri Lanka, and Hong Kong. Afghanistan winning the silver medal last time. That was a big surprise and great for Asian cricket. Just one to go in the over. I think he's coming over the wicket to Pavan, to the left-hander. Park Taekwon. Just six overs left after this delivery. Some cuties in the grandstand. I'm not sure if they know much about cricket. They're enjoying their day out with their mum. Farooq will bowl his last over. That was Parvin's spell gone. 2 for 11 off his 4. And really tying down the Koreans in this middle stage of the innings. That's an interesting shot from Lee, though. Oh, he's lumbering Park. Short of his ground, surely. Well, the umpire's given him the benefit of the doubt. He was really struggling to turn and make that one, Park Taekwon. Looked to be maybe a foot out. Let's have a look. Throw come in nicely. Farooq's there. Pounces on the ball. Wickets are broken. Yes, a foot. I was about right. And Farooq still had time to turn around and see him out of his ground. Probably needed to appeal a bit more vociferously there to convince the umpire. It was all a fait accompli, really. Just joking with his teammates, giving his call on the run out as well, I think. So after that risky two, Park just dusting himself off and getting ready. I've been impressed with Lee Sung-wook down the other end. He's batting well. Not a big hitter of the ball, but placing it nicely after that last shot there, just spooning it through the covers. Ooh. Facing a very good standard of bowling here. He has a 9 off 14 delivery, so ticking along the run rate, and he's seen a lot of his teammates falling at the other end. So gets through for a single there as well. Well, he's a big strapping boy, this Park Taekwon, and I'd love to see him have a go. There's only 5.5 overs left. They're 5 wickets down. comes there. Get a look at there, Farooq. Park still not off the mark after seven deliveries. It's Julian Fountain, the man in charge for Korean cricket. He's had a reap at that one. Like harvesting the rice there. Big sweep. And he's off the mark after eight deliveries. This will be the last ball of Farooq's spell. Started well early. Rips through the Korean order at one stage. And just held back the scoring rate in the last few overs. That's a good spell from Farooq. With three wickets. Three for 13 off his four overs, Farooq. So good bowling. I guess we'll see some, perhaps some medium pace to wrap up the innings. A good bowler starting off there in Malaysian attack, or maybe the captain might fancy bowl himself, Faiz, now. So just cruising along at 3.27 and over. Doubt if this score will trouble the Malaysians outwardly. So there's another left arm spinner on. I thought for Sri Lanka had a mortgage on the left arm bowlers. Well, Malaysia also with Nizam. He's bowled one over already for seven runs. So coming back for his second spell. Ray's the umpire. Gets his arms out for a wide. So Park slowly getting going. You can see a lot. Look at that. It's huge, Park. Great to see him start really hitting with the full face of the bat. I think he probably fancies these medium paces a bit more than these niggly little left arm spinners. Nizam with his third delivery. A little bit of turn, and Lee decides he's taking off, and that's good. Good running. Placed it nicely. Yeah, called it. Saw his partner respond, and away they went. They'll need runs like this. There's Park. Very much has been in Park as far as his batting gear goes.
Well done. That's it, boys.
His last international outing was in June, where he got some good bags of wickets. 3 for 24 against Oman, 5 for 49 against Italy. He's just decided to give that one a miss, going down leg side.
Well done, boys. Well done.
2 for 55 against Singapore, and 4 for 32 against Jersey. So a wicket taker, Nizam. That was in the arc, wasn't it, Tenord? Lee's decided to scamper off here. What a brilliant runner between wickets he is, and he's a real baseball style, isn't he? Stealer of bases as Korea go to 53 for 5 off 16. We've had about an hour of cricket, 16 overs. Korea 53 for 5 and bowling change here as we look at the field. Fielders out on the leg side boundary. is Suharil with his second spell. And that's a good shot. Effective. So they've decided to get going in this last four overs. Suharil, who opened the bowling, coming back, getting a bit short in park, can obviously hit the ball. Nice shot from Park Taekwon. Well, he started very slowly, Park, so let's hope he can string together a few big hits here. And Suharil comes back very nicely at him. High backlift. It's it to the batsman. Focusing on the fielders rather than the holes. Suharil's 25 years old. Good all-rounder for Malaysia. Down the ground from Park. Just the single. And you know Lee will just be poking and prodding. Get a single, get Park back on face. At the same tournament in Singapore a few months ago, Suharil getting some good scores with the bat. 46 not out, 44, 43 not out. He's gone over the top this time, Lee. Placed it just nicely for a single. It's the big man Park on strike.
Right arm or wrong?
Come, boys.
Oh, he's hit this one too. It's gone down to the fielder. Oh, he had the stretch, Farouk. And they've come back for two. This is what the crowd have come to see. Some runs being scored. Farouk, well, he's had his three wickets in the field. He's happy. Tough chance there. Would have been a great catch. Look at Park. He really gives it a big swing. And shot drifted too, didn't it? Slowly drifting round square. And Farouk was a little bit thrown by that. If that had stuck, it would have been a spectacular catch. Interesting with Farouk earlier in the game, wearing some sort of finger guard there. I'm not sure if the legality of that. Definitely have to ask permission of the umpire and probably the opposing batsman to wear something like that. Well, it's Lee this time who hits it high, wide and handsome. And not high and wide and handsome enough. It's Amin down there on the boundary. It would have been a fantastic shot from Lee. We saw him poking and probing and not really opening his shoulders. Gave that one a decent belt. I mean, making some great ground there, covering 10, 15 metres across, and made it look pretty simple in the end, didn't he? What a shame. Korea were just accelerating the score there. And Lee Sung-wook out for 12. Not a bad effort off 20. But a six there would have helped the scoring rate a bit, and he knows he's disappointed he got the start. Probably didn't have to do that, to be fair. Could have just given the strike to Park, who seems to be hitting the ball very cleanly now. Lee Kwan Hee enters the fray. Two-year-old, and he's very much the face of Korean cricket, Lee, as Park faces up. It's single. Lee, the batsman here on strike. One of the first Koreans to play in the local league when all the Pakistani, Indians and Sri Lankans were playing and set up their league during the early 90s. And slowly but surely he garnered a lot of local players for Seoul's league. He's also the executive director of the Cricket Association.
Oh yeah.
So he's a busy man.
That's it, boys, that's it. Keep it, dot balls. Keep going, boys, keep going. Done, done, done. Good try, good try.
So Lee gets off the mark. I just think for the match's sake, it'd be great here to see Park Taekwon just get a few lusty blows in. I'm sure the Malaysians fancy a bit of batting practice too on this wicket. Knees up. Nice little scooter of a delivery. And that's the 18th over gone. Only two left. And Korea 63 for 6. Some of the locals enjoying the cricket here on the morning of a Saturday at the Asian Games. It's Nasril opened the bowling, coming back for his second spell. And just get an over in here. He had two overs for 9 runs. I'd like to see Park Taekwon have a go at this sort of bowling. This is Lee on strike, so if he can get a single to get the big man down the other end. Nothing there though. Park has his eye in now. He's 11 after 19. And it's a shame to see him there, just down the other end watching. 3.47, not enough really in T20 cricket. This time it's a single. 9 balls left. Yeah. Looking at the way that Park has this big backlift, I'm sure Nasril will be thinking in terms of pitching the ball really up there at that Yorker length at the toes of Park, so he doesn't have any room to get those arms free. Nasril just wiping the ball on his forehead there, putting a little bit of sun cream probably in the mix there to shine the ball up. Now that's exactly what he did. Pitched up nicely. Good cricket from Nasril, and Park Taekwon's innings, brave as it was, comes to an end. Well, if he'd bowled short, Park, those big swinging shots that we saw earlier would have benefited. But look at that, perfect, perfect length from Nasril, and canny cricket. So Park Taekwon out for 11 off 21. We've seen a lot of those scores in the teens with their good starts, but nobody going on to help the Korean cause. Top scorer so far, Cho Sung-hoon, 19 of 32. His fellow opener with 14, Seo Il-won of 24. And they look pretty composed, if not aggressive. Bung Ki ready to come in. Next batsman though, Cha In-ho. That Kim Kyung-sik is coming in. Well, The skipper, Kim Kunsik. Interesting stance, isn't it? And, oh, well. See, that's what happens when you give the big swing at the ball. Could go anywhere. Oh. So they've got a couple there. Kunsik. The bigger backlift there. Got down on the ball at the last minute, though. Nazrul did what he could. Just kept it up in the block hole. Just managed to clamp down on it with the bottom edge. No secret, I guess, for the Malaysians that the Koreans would perhaps bat this way, some of them. Been preparing for it, surely. Again, nice length, and oh, Kunsik decided to gallop through. Goodness knows what he was thinking there. So the skipper's out, that was short and sweet. 19 overs have gone. Only one left, Julian Fountain playing his poker face there. I'm sure he's not happy though. Korea 66 for 8.
Returning to the bowl of the Malaysia, this time for the final game. Number 17, Suresh Nabalanda.
Hong Ki, a left-hander, but he'll be down the non-facing end. Suresh comes back for his last over. Just a single to start with. Wily veteran, good man to have the bowl the last over. Here's the run out on the last ball of the over. The captain, don't know what he was thinking there, hit the ball directly to the fielder. Navaratnam has none for two off his two overs. He's been very economical. Tried to slam that one into the pitch, but didn't get it more than a couple of foot off the deck there. Been the real hero of Malaysian cricket over the years, making his debut in 1993. Left arm spinner in the team, Parvin, not even born. Till 5 years after that, in fact. Now this seems like a popular shot for Koreans to play. We call it the French cut. I have to start calling it the Korean cut. Obviously with their high back lifts, they're going to get a lot of balls down there to fine leg, especially off the medium paces if they don't judge the pace properly. Only three balls left. Suresh comes in. Nice delivery. Slower ball too, held it back nicely. Lee Kwan Lee has done a good job since he's come into bat. He's got 5 runs off 7 balls. Off cutter there from Suresh, and virtually all his runs have come from inside edges. But he battles on, 6 runs off 8. So instructions there from the Malaysian coach. So that's the end of 20 overs for Korea, and they managed to get 71 runs in their 20 overs for the loss of 8 wickets. And I don't think Malaysia will be too concerned with this total, but of course it's a game of cricket, got to get the runs on the board. Korea started well. The opening pair put on 32 runs in just over 8 overs at 4 and over, so they were rattling along reasonably well, of course with the benefit of the power play. But once we saw the introduction of Suresh Navaratnam and the slow left arm bowlers, they really were dragged down. Lost wickets regularly, and the run rate dropped to 1 or 2 and over by mid-innings, so they were in real trouble. A couple of bright efforts there at the end by Lee, who got 6 not out. And Park Taekwon as well with 11 off 21. Lee. Lee Sung Wook, 12 off his 20. And for the bowling, Farooq was the top wicket taker down the bottom there, 3 for 13 off his 4. Parvin, the young 16-year-old prodigy, 2 for 11. And also some good efforts economically there by Suresh. Only 7 off his 3 overs. So well done to Malaysia. They have China in this group as well. I'm sure they're watching with interest as well. Please join us in a few moments' time. We'll be back with the Malaysian chase. They require only 72 runs to win. You're watching the Asian Games 2014.